Hello everyone, welcome to the session on electronic mail. This is Kanchan Khedikar, working as an assistant professor in Computer Science and Engineering Department at Walchan Institute of Technology, Solapur. Electronic mail is one of the most popular internet service. So let's start with the learning outcome. At the end of this session, student will be able to describe the architecture of electronic mail using four scenarios. Let me explain what is electronic mail, which is abbreviated as email. Email is a digital mechanism for exchanging message through internet or intranet communication platform. Email system are based on store and forward model, in which email server system accept, forward, deliver and store the messages on behalf of users who only need to connect to the email infrastructure. Now let's see the email architecture in detail. Email architecture gives four scenario. The first scenario is the very simple scenario, whereas the fourth one is a very complex, but the fourth is the most popular scenario. But before starting the first scenario of email architecture, let me explain user agent. So it is the first component of electronic mail system in the that is known as user agent. It provides the service to the user to make the process of sending and receiving a message easier. User agent performs the various tasks. So it performs composing the message, reading the messages, then replying to messages, then forwarding to the messages and handling the mailboxes. There are two types of user agents, that is command driven user agent and GUI-based user agent. But these two types of user agent we'll see in my next video. So let's start with the first scenario of electronic mail. In this scenario, the sender and the receiver of the email are users or application program on the same mail server, and they are directly connected to the shared mail server. The administrator has created one mailbox for each user where the received messages are stored. Look at this diagram. In this diagram, user agent is created by the Alice. Actually, here two hosts are present. One is named as Alice and the another one is Bob. When the Alice wants to send a message to a Bob, she runs her user agent and send the message and store that message to Bob's mailbox. Whenever the Bob want to receive or retrieve the message, he just use its mail, his mail agent, okay? And at that time, he runs a program, that is user agent, and he just receive the mail from the mailboxes according to his convenience. So in a nutshell, when the sender and the receiver of an email are on the same mail server, we need only two user agents. For example, intranet mail server. It is used for exchange of a simple mail between the employees of an organization. So, require only two user agents. Now, next important scenario is known as second scenario of email. Now, in this scenario, the sender and the receiver of the email are the users or the application programs on two different mail servers. The messages need to be sent over the internet. It needs user agent and message transfer agent, which is abbreviated as MTAs. Look at this diagram. In this diagram, two mail servers are shown. Now here, when Alice want to send a message, she just run her user agent, which is run on her own system. Then these messages are sent to the mail server. Here the Alice mail server, or we can say that on her side, the mail server maintain one queue, which is known as a spool of a messages. Then these messages are one by one sent to the MTA client, that is message transfer agent client, which is run on the client machines, that is Alice machine. Okay, then these messages are one by one sent to the MTA server, which is nothing but the Bob's mail server. Now here, Whenever the message is retrieved by the Bob, Bob runs his own user agent, and that program accesses the message from the mailboxes which is sent by the Alice. But there is a client-server communication in between the MTA client and MTA server of Alice and Bob, and for that they uses the internet. So, for example, in the second scenario of email, like client-server program is used on the internet. The server needs to run all the time because it does not know when the client will ask for the connection. So that's why server has to run for all the time. So in the nutshell, when the sender and the receiver of an email are on different mail servers, we need two user agents and a pair of MTAs, that is client-server program. Now, just think for a while and pause the video for a while and just write down the answer of this question. Intranet is a company's internal web, whether the statement is true or false. Yes, the statement is true because intranet is a company's internal web and uses the TCP/IP, that is Transmission Control Protocol or Internet Protocol, and HTTP and other internet protocols. Its main object is to share the company's information among the employees. Let's move toward the third scenario of email architecture. Now here, Alice is separated from her mail server. In previous scenario, that means in second scenario, Alice is directly connected to the mail server. But in this third scenario, the situation is different. Here, Alice is separated from her mail server. Alice is either connected to the mail server via a point-to-point WAN, that is wide area network, such as dial-up modem, SDL, or a cable modem. Or she can also connected to the mail server via LAN in an organization that uses one mail server for handling the emails. All users need to send their messages to the mail server only, and then only all these messages are forwarded to the internet. Okay. In this third scenario, two pair of MTA client server programs are needed. Now let me explain with this diagram. In this diagram, look at the UA. Whenever the Alice having a message to send to a Bob, she just run her user agent and send the message to the MTA client. After that, the MTA client connects her with the mail server where the MTA server is present with the help of point-to-point connection. Or we can say that the MTA client establishes the connection in between Alice and her mail server. Here in this system, a queue of messages is present, that is also known as pool of messages. These messages are transmitted one by one, or these are forwarded one by one to the MTA client. After that, these MTA client forward these messages to the MTA server, which is nothing but the mail server of recipient. And here our recipient is Bob. Whenever Bob want to access the mails, or whenever Bob want to access the message, he just check his mailbox where the mails are, or the mails are stored from the Alice. So here two pairs of MTAs are used. That means here we can say the first pair of MTA client and server, and the another pair of MTA client and server which is connected through the internet. So when the sender is connected to the mail server via LAN or a WAN, we need two UAs and two pair of MTAs, that is client-server program. Now, look at the fourth scenario. In this fourth scenario, both Alice and Bobs are connected to mail servers via LAN or WAN. Now, here the condition is different. After the message has arrived at the Bob mail server, Bob need to receive it. But here we need another set of client server agent, and that agent is known as Message Access Agent, which is abbreviated as MAAs. Bob uses an MAA client to retrieve his message. The client sends a request to the MAA server, which is running all the time, and requests the transfer of the messages. Now, look at this diagram, which is the perfect and the popular example of email. Nowadays, we are using this type of scenario. Here, when Alice want to send the message, she just run her user agent and send the message to the MTA client. MTA client establish the connection with the MTA server, okay, which is present in the mail server of Alice site. Here, the messages are stored into a queue, and one by one the messages are transmitted to the MTA client. After that, MTA client connect via internet to the MTA server of the recipient mail server. Recipient mail server forward all the messages to the recipient mailbox. Now, up till this, the scenario is same as that of the third scenario. Okay, now the situation is changed, and here to retrieve the messages from the mailboxes, Bob require the message access agent. That's why in this fourth scenario, a pair of message access agent is used, and here it contains the message access agent server and message access agent client. So here message access agent server send or forward the messages to the message access agent client, and finally, and these two are connected via point-to-point network. And finally, Bob retrieve the messages, but to retrieve these messages, he has to run his own user agent program. And in this way, the data transmission takes place in the fourth scenario of email. When both the senders and the receivers are connected to the mail servers via LAN or a WAN, we need two user agents, two pair of message access agent, that is client server program, and a single pair of message access agent, that is again a client server program. Now, here Bob cannot bypass the mail server and use the MTA server directly. So that's why Bob need to run the MAA, that is message access agent. Both needs another pair of client server program, that is message access program. MTA client server program is a push program. The client pushes the message to the server, and MAA client server program is a pull program because the client needs to pull the messages from the server. So in this video, we have seen all four scenarios of email. For this lecture, I have referred these references. Thank you.